Welcome back. Doctors have learned a lot about COVID-19 in the past couple of weeks, from symptoms to treatments to testing. So earlier today, I talked with an MU Healthcare ER doctor about what you should know. Dr. Sampson, thank you so much for joining us today. My first question for you is, how has testing for COVID-19 really evolved over the past couple of weeks? And what about the turnaround time for testing?
So we've seen a big change in testing. A few weeks ago when it first started, there was a pretty strict criteria. A lot of it revolved around travel history. Now that we've seen community spread of the disease, we're looking more towards symptoms that people might present with. With that as well, now that there's some, more testing available, we've also seen a decrease in turnaround time. So initially it may have taken a few days, sometimes even a week to get results back here. But now we've come down to where we can get results pretty much in about less than a day.
So let's talk about what symptoms are you guys targeting? And now that we're, you know, in the spring time of year, how do you make the difference between COVID-19 symptoms and allergies?
So that can be challenging. We know that about half of patients will have a fever, and also about half may have a dry cough. But then people can present with a lot of the other just sort of mild symptoms, muscle aches, runny nose, red eyes. So that can make it challenging to differentiate between allergies. We are sometimes looking at, are they near other people who have been having these symptoms? Or sometimes just based on if they may have allergy type symptoms, we will test them just to make sure that they don't have COVID-19.
What is your all's current treatment plan for COVID-19?
So thankfully, most people actually have pretty mild symptoms. A lot of that treatment is focused on just sort of medicine for muscle aches, such as Tylenol or over-the-counter pain medicine and fever control. The more serious patients are those the ones that do require admission. And a lot of those patients sometimes require oxygen support. And there's many different ways that could be, from something as simple as prongs in the nose to, unfortunately, some patients require to be placed on a ventilator.
How are you keeping your all staff safe, and do you have enough PPE?
So currently we do. We have enough PPE right now, but we're always concerned about future PPE running short. To stay safe, I mean, a lot of it is just observing good habits, making sure you're getting plenty of sleep, doing what we tell the public, washing our hands, not touching our face, and then also trying sometimes not bringing home the clothes that we've worked in. So a lot of people will change when they get to work and then change out of their dirty scrubs or clothing before they head home to their families.
Now, Dr. Sampson, you're an ER doctor. What is it like for you to work on the front lines of this outbreak?
So this is really what we train for. This is emergency medicine, but a lot of it is preparation. So we thankfully have word from our colleagues in other areas where they've been hit hard in New York and New Orleans and Detroit. So we're using that information that we're getting from them in order to be prepared when the patients arrive here in mid-Missouri.
Well, Dr. Sampson, we certainly appreciate everything that you guys are doing as you battle this pandemic, and we appreciate you sharing your time with us today.
Great. Thank you for having me. And we appreciate all the community support for MU Healthcare as well during this time.